You can now create a webinar in Microsoft Teams for attendees to register if they want to attend it. Let's see how you can set up a webinar for courses like teacher professional development or student revision courses. From the calendar, click on the down arrow next to New Meeting. You will see the webinar option, which you can select. This has now displayed the webinar details for you to fill in, such as the name of the webinar and the time the webinar will begin and end. You will also notice there is an option at the top which allows you to choose if participants need to register for the webinar or if it is available only to people in your organization or to everyone. If you see the everyone option grayed out, you will need to contact your IT admin staff to enable this option. Alternatively, you could disable the registration for the webinar, but this will make the webinar just like a normal Microsoft Teams meeting. In this example, we will create a revision webinar for students to attend before an exam, so I will only allow students in my school to attend. There is an area you can add a list of presenters to, from either within your organization, or you can enter the email address of an external participant. Please note this is only for inviting presenters, and so you should not add in any attendees, such as students here. The students will need to use the registration form to receive an invite to the webinar. Now the presenters have been included, when you click send, an email invite is sent to each presenter. They can then use the email join link to join the webinar. Once you have finished entering the details, click on the view registration form to customize it. You will see on the basic form it contains a title, a time for the webinar, a description box, and the list of speakers. These details are all visible to those who want to register to attend the webinar, such as students, so make sure it's written for them. If you have a list of speakers, you can write a bio for each speaker so that the attendees can know who is presenting at the webinar. The attendees will need to enter their first name and surname and a valid email address for the webinar join link to be sent to. However, you can add more fields by clicking on Add Field. This displays other preset information you could ask attendees to fill in, or you could make your own, which attendees will need to either type an answer or select an answer from a list of options. If you'd like, you can add a picture banner to the top of your registration form. Click on Upload an Image. You can now click on Upload an Image. You can then use the slider to zoom into the image. Now you can click Done. Now click on Save, and you can then preview what the registration form looks like. If you're happy with the registration form, you can click on Copy Registration Link, and then you can share it or post it for others to click on, and then register for the webinar. You are able to view the registration list by entering into the Edit Webinar Details window from the calendar. From here, you can click on the registration to download the current list of attendees who have registered for the webinar. This will download an Excel file which you can open and see the information the attendees entered when registering. Before the webinar, I recommend you sort out the webinar settings. In most webinars, you probably don't want attendees unmuting or showing their camera as it will distract others in the webinar. Therefore, go to the Meetings Options menu from the Webinar Edit screen. From here, you can prevent attendees from bypassing the lobby and only allowing the speakers you have invited to do so. You can also check which specific people have presenting rights. You can even mute all attendees so that they cannot interrupt the presenter. Another option to consider is to disable meeting chat before and after the webinar, or you can allow it only during the webinar. Lastly, you can enable live reactions, where attendees can use emojis to interact with the presenter. Once you have set all the options, remember to click Save. Microsoft Teams webinar meetings will be available to a wide range of licenses. However, for the rest of 2021, anyone with a valid Microsoft 365 license will have access to creating webinars, but Microsoft may limit this to certain licenses from 2022 onward. Currently, only the first 1,000 attendees in these webinars will be able to interact during the webinar, such as talking or switching on their camera. After you reach 1,000 attendees, the next 9,000 will be view-only attendees, but they will not be able to interact. They will only be able to watch. Click on the Watch Next video to learn how to share and improve your audio during a Microsoft Teams meeting or webinar.